points, Tony Jones.
Well, Danny, you look at the scoreboard and you see that sort of a score. What do you say to the players in a situation like that?
Well, the score's 11 out of 10. It's the only way we can look at it. Essendon have just beat us at all facets of the game. We just have to start again. You know, the whole football world's going to watch and see how we react the second half. So, it's up to each and every one of us just to put our hand up for the club now.
A more aggressive Richmond in the second half, is that what you're intimating?
Oh, well, we need to do something. I thought we'd turn around a little bit in our attack on the ball. Halfway during that quarter, but we let ourselves down with bad disposal.
All right, good luck, Danny. Danny Frawley joining us there. Back to the commentary box.
Thanks very much to Danny Frawley joining Tony Jones as we start this third quarter. This is the biggest halftime margin ever between these two clubs. 67 points, beating round 12, 1985, when the Bombers led by 63. Dennis Cometti with the second half on AFL on 9.
Hill directs it down, but straight to King. This is Tawney, swings it out very wide towards right half forward. Richardson knocks it towards the boundary line. Jacobs tracks it out there. Roden comes across on the angle. And out they go. The margin, 67 points.
And no Sam Newman at halftime tonight. Sam, of course, opened his $4 million restaurant last night, driving Ferraris then in Tasmania this weekend. What a life.
As you do.
Tossed in. Otten's in front. Directs it down. Houlihan, hurriedly. Wellman back in the opposite direction. High ball to the wing. This will be interesting. Reaching over the top, Stafford runs away from Hurd. Don't often see that. A telling kick inside the 50. Hill goes up, takes the mark. Growing in stature by the weeks. Johnson, Ramanauskas on the outer side. Kicks it up towards the wing. Blumfield takes it. He's off. Forward of the wing, kicks down towards the attacking 50. Wonderful kick. Lloyd the mark. 60 metres out, spots McCurry over his head. Put half an arm up. In goes Kellaway. Kellaway was pushed in the back. An arm went up, bent at the elbow.
Sure, what Mark McCurry was doing was he trying to tap it on over the back to James Hurd at the end.
Might have got a bit of leave it on that one, I think, from James. Here's Kellaway from half-back flank to King. Tivendale. Now the Tigers are starting to run. Tawney at half forward. Kicks inside 50. Good kick. And from memory, that's the first time tonight the Tigers have put on about five different disposals that have hit the mark.
They've gone three tools in their forward 50. They've got Richardson, Ottens, and now Holland. And I think it's really to try and keep Dustin Fletcher honest. And it now provides Holland with a chance against Wellman with a height advantage. And if they could get Richardson and Jacobs one out, you'd still fancy Richardson in that situation.
Ben Holland, a touch over 50-50 from this position. It'll take a magnificent kick from here. Badly needed is the understatement of the night. It won't come from that kick. Over the head of the pack, Ottens is still in play. Tries to tap it to Roden. He's thrown to the ground. And Hill is playing the game of his career so far. This is his eighth game of football. Throw in.
It's important that Richmond make sure that Sean Wellman minds a man and doesn't run off and be a creative player.
Oh. Ottens grabbed high, snapped at goal. It'll come back. And Brad Ottens, who consistently at least has got to the front at throw-ins and ball-ups, and reaps the reward on this occasion.
Well, often you'll find out more about players when their side is getting smashed and they've had an ordinary first half of football. You can find out more about the way, what sort of character they've got by the way they hit back. And he's got himself involved in a couple of passages, and there's still an opportunity for him to have an impact on this game of footy, as indeed there is for the rest of his teammates who are in the same boat. They've got a point to prove. Danny Frawley said it at halftime with Tony Jones. The whole footy world is watching how they react to that humiliating first half.
Here's the reverse angle right over the shoulder of Brad Ottens. Has been a very lean night for him for his first score of the evening and the Tigers' third goal. He comes in and has put it through the middle. 3-6-24 to 13-7-85.
Challenge to Greg Stafford too, Dermot, in the middle of the ground. He, against an inexperienced player in Hill, who's in very good form, he's got to impose himself on this game as well. As we see the free kick there, no question it was a too high. But I think Stafford's got, he's got to stand up as well in this third quarter.
There's no doubt Greg Stafford's probably only about 50-60% in the fitness capacity to where he wants to be. So a game like this after half-time, it's going to go a long way to his fitness base.
Ottens gets his first goal. He kicked at least two goals in 13 matches last season. His best effort against the Bombers, four, round 22 last year. Rucks go at it. Hill knocks it down. Hurd getting busy. Sweeping hand pass out wide. Ramanauskas, little 1-2 with Hurd, goes off a step. Now the Tiger is down, and Tawney will get the free kick, I think.
Yeah, Heffernan set him on his behind play. They just were at each other and indiscriminately set him on his backside.
Heartening signs for the Tigers. Knights in front, had it knocked away by Heffernan. Knights the recovery, arches the back, slips away. Very high kick inside the 50. Down goes a bomber this time. And the umpire replies in kind. Mark Johnson lays it off. Ramanauskas across the goal face. Nice kick. Comes to Hill. He's at left half back. Running hard down the ground is Blumfield. Meters in the clear. Can gather this and go. The kick, not terrific. Has to check. Looks to the middle. McVeigh comes on a lead. He's got it now. 60 meters from goal. Lloyd to the pocket. McVeigh honors the lead. Well, it needed another 2 meters. It bounces out of bounds. Let's go down to the dock.
Yeah, Dennis, Mark McCurry came off about 2 minutes ago, having some attention to a left groin muscle. He signaled to the bench that he wanted to come off, just having some massage work, but he's not moving all that well.
Throw in for the Bombers, 40 metres around from their goal. Have a look at this. Carousel, a left foot kick. Zantac marked for the Tigers. A bit cute, Gary?
A bit cute, I thought.
Bowden, thumping kick. Stafford at half-back flank. Once again, the best that's offered is a 50-50 contest. Jacobs is there, brings it to the ground. He has held his position nicely. Couldn't quite get enough purchase on the soccer kick. And Houlihan's handball finds the boundary line throw in.
You talked about Greg Stafford a few seconds ago. I just get the feeling that he's... I'll have a look at that. The top five possession getters on the ground. Only one Richmond player within that. And Clinton King gets dragged out of the centre by his Essendon opponent when he's in there now. You just get the feeling that Greg Stafford's just overruling Hilly with his body size now. Hilly's rucked unchanged all night.
That's right.
It'll be a bit of a clinic for him now, wouldn't it, Dermot? Kevin Sheddy just leave Hill on there, let him go?
Probably just give him a bit of a breather, probably just before three-quarter time or after.
Stafford doing as Dermot just described. Kicks it inside 50. Fletcher, one hand, too good. What a night Dustin Fletcher's having.
Good player. I've sometimes been a bit critical that he doesn't always get the most dangerous forward, but, gee, tonight he's had every dangerous forward that's gone down there and taken them on and beaten them.
Ramanauskas, tremendous link man. Yeah. The boy from Noble Park goes short. Forced the night.
Oh.
Handball's off. Heffernan, centre wing. Ninth possession for Heffernan, comes forward. Good mark by McVeigh. It almost gets cleaned up by Carousella. Lloyd to the pocket. McVeigh again. Kicks to him. Lloyd gets to the front. Gasper takes it to the boundary line. We'll have another throw in. It's the Bombers 85, leading Richmond 24. We've played 7.5 in the third term.
And that kick to force tonight was called play on, not 15. Gee, it looked 15. Boundary throw in. Over the top, Carousella falls in front. Campbell, Kellaway, quick hands away. Tawney, look out. Well, Tawney gets a late whistle, and the umpire, I think, more affected by Tawney's response after the collision. Not sure there was much there.
I think you're right there, Dennis.
Just a glancing
off the ground. Yeah.
It promised danger, though, didn't it?
Well, yeah.
Tawney, short, Kellaway.
15?
Well, I don't think so there. I'm confused.
Good news for the Tigers is Joel Bowden appears to be running smoothly this third quarter.
Kellaway over the top. Tawney, right back pocket. To centre half back. Fiora takes it, plays on. Nothing ahead, very static. Knights is breaking. Fiora goes in that direction. High ball. Heffernan too tall.
Just a structural thing when you have to go long in a slow play to Matthew Knights against Heffernan.
Around the outer side, he cruises. Lovely finish too. Going back with a flight, Henneman. He's got this ball at right half forward. Crowd wanting 50. Campbell does the gentlemanly thing and foxes it. So Henneman, 65 metres out, centering kick. Lloyd and Gaspar in from the side. Fiora did very well. Strong mark by the youngster. That's better. Zantuck chips it into the path of Kellaway. Wow, what was he thinking? Caro Seller came up to meet him. Barden, like a steeplechaser. Houlihan towards the wing. Richo, well, he made it hard.
Got the staggers.
He went to ground before he went for the mark. Kicks it up.
Good kick.
To the forward 50. Bombers there again. Peverell, front and square, knocks it down. Wellman, good play. Peverell again with the Shepherd. Does the hard things, Damien Peverell. Forster Knight, no 15 that occasion. Jacobs. Johnson. Hasn't he been fantastic tonight? Jason Johnson to McVeigh, who's coming into the play as well. Back to Johnson for another possession. Thumps it long inside 50. Lloyd will fly from behind. No, he sits and waits because his teammate Carousella backed into position and held a very strong mark. He'll kick from 45 metres.
That passage of play there, you had Carousella and McVeigh against three Richmond opponents and led them a merry dance. Sorry, Johnson and McVeigh led them a merry dance, just two against three. They're not only winning the 50-50s now, they're winning the ones with the lower percentage chances.
Two goals, two for the night. 65% probability over 4 years for Blake Carousella from here. And well, that goes up a few percent now as he kicks his third goal, and Essendon kick away to 14-7-91, Richmond 3-6-24.
Watch them here just work through it, Gary.
Yeah, they did, Dermot. They just couldn't get a hand on them in the end, Richmond. They had too much time, and then the mark. Well, Aaron Fiore's got to do better than that. Simple as that. I mean, that Blake Carousella's a talented player, but not renowned for being super strong overhead.
No.
And that's just a state of mind thing, you know. Not conceding, but not as desperate as they were last week.
91 players, 24. Third term, Friday night football from the MCG. Massive crowd, one-sided game so far. And it's back in the middle.
Wayne Campbell cannot get into the middle of the ground. That's how good this Essendon side are setting up.
Stafford knocked it down. Peverell's hand pass out wide. Massidi on his knees. Henneman into the path of Blumfield. 55 metres out, unstoppable.
Yeah. Well, I think Justin Blumfield has been absolutely magnificent tonight. He's got that rare ability to play on someone, but then win footy. And he's had 22 touches for the afternoon. He's just, or the evening rather, and been on Joel Bowden for a fair amount of the game as well. So he's a valuable player. He and Heffernan were missing for most of last year in because of injury. And you underestimate their value, those two blokes.
Matthew Lloyd going at his third. He's kicked 46 career goals against the Tigers since his debut back in 1995. His best effort, seven. Round two of 2000. We're right behind him. It's swinging left to right. Hasn't quite got it together tonight, a behind.
Hard to see where Richmond are going to get their goals at the moment.
Tigers to defensive 50. Callaway handballs onto Campbell. The 1-2 going Bowden over the top. Tawney, Zilla to centre wing. Building something this time. Roden gets out and almost takes the mark. Underneath the pack, Knights, he's grabbed. Cracker goes to ground, knocks it out. Roden goes again. The two youngsters combining close to the boundary line. Roden's kick is a beauty. It's a goal! What an absolute beauty for his first goal in football. David Roden. The boy from Broadmeadows gets his first major, and that is one highlight for the Tigers to take home tonight.
But if they can't take something out of that, Richmond, then they never will. I said it's hard to see where they're coming from. I wouldn't have picked this. He came out of full forward and led.
He actually led competently too, didn't he?
Almost took it overhead, followed up with a second and third effort, and I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. I reckon he meant that.
Yep.
So that's got to lift Richmond. The youngest player, or the least experienced player on the ground from a Richmond point of view, leading the way. So just see if this is a spark for them. Well done.
Well, they've kicked four goals tonight, two of them destined for the highlight reel. A kick by Houlihan and then Roden. So far too few. Stafford took a while, fell at his feet. Zantuck did well. Zilla lays it off. Houlihan kicks it down towards half forward. In front, Richardson used his body well. Breaks away from Jacobs. Runs to 50. Bending it. Not quite enough. was stayed out to the right. They did that earlier, back-to-back goals in the space of a minute. And there again, history almost repeated itself. This is Wellman.
Eighth mark for Matty Richardson running out onto that half-forward flank.
Untidy kick into space, and Johnson had no alternative but to take it out of bounds as we go down to Peter Larkins.
Yeah, Dennis, Mark McCurry trying to do some easy running on the boundary, looking very uncomfortable with that sore left groin, so they may not chance him on a cold night like tonight.
Coming up to the 15-minute mark of the third term, 61-point margin in favour of Essendon. Smokin' Joe Macidi, the left-foot kick, up to the wing position. Peverell once again holds his line and runs past Campbell and handles beautifully over the top. Barnard inside, Blumfield kicks long, looking for Lloyd, who'll fly from behind. Hurd across the front. Oh. Play on. Derm, your thoughts?
He got a few fumbles on it, Ed. I never thought he truly secured the ball, though. Good decision.
Bowden at half-back for the Tigers. Puts it out in front of Ottens from behind. Fletcher spoils. Wellman always have the numbers, the Bombers. Downfield. Hurd will get the free kick. And now he's called the play on. McVay. Lloyd this time underneath it. It falls to Hill. He kicked the ripper last week. He goes off the ground. No cigar on this occasion, though, and it's through for 1 point. Well, it was all happening out there. There were whistles on, play, plays on, stop, go. In the end, a point to the Bombers, and they stretch their lead out to 62 points.
Kevin Dale. Kick. Nice kick. Beauty. Zilla released into space. Goes looking for Roden and or Cameron. Cameron going back, dropped the mark, picks up the footy, snaps and misses. Oh, gee.
That was a shame, because I thought David Roden had his opponent, Mark Johnson, done on the lead as well. He's actually leading from full forward in a competent fashion, young David Roden.
Well, he's got a hunger for the footy, trying to get a hands on it that you'd expect from a second gamer, that perhaps some players out there are not as hungry.
Fletcher, straight up the middle. Macidi, they take pride in doing this. Essendon, Heffernan, Hurd. Now off the ball, a Tiger's gone down. Forget this. A free kick to the Tigers back in the middle. Heffernan can't believe it.
Yeah. Watch this off the ball stuff was the call. Yeah, he spread the arms out with the shepherd and it just knocked Holland down.
Holland towards the pocket, honouring the lead from Richo. Gets tangled in his feet and across the line. Free so far, Tigers 12, Essendon 9.
Oh. There you go, nothing in it.
Well,
nothing in it. I mean, you'd almost drag your player for such an insipid effort to knock one down.
A couple of Logie award-winning performances from the Tigers tonight. That's about the only awards they'll get, though. The Bombers have taken everything else before them. Hey, look at this one. Out it comes to Mark Johnson, and away he races. Another bounce, takes them on to the half-forward flank. The kick in was an ordinary one. And the mark has been taken by Kellaway.
It's getting a bit untidy from an Essendon point of view. They've just started to miss some targets and... some loose marking through the middle of the ground.
Houlihan's kick stayed in the air a long time. Bowden had to wait, but was good enough to keep his feet. Handball's on to Zantuck, who sometime his disposal lets him down, and that was one of them. Close to the boundary line, Ramanaskas does it beautifully. Roden takes him to the line. We'll have a throw in.
There's young Andrew Cracker. The good news for West Richmond this quarter, Edward, is that the Tigers have gone inside their 50 on 11 occasions and Essendon 8. So at least they're matching with some intensity in the middle of the ground.
Roden and Cracker, two young blokes leading the way, two on a forward, from the forward line.
Ottens gets to the front, over the top to Knights.
That's better.
Ball goes forward once again. Guess who? Dustin Fletcher. He just reads it beautifully. He reacts far quicker than the Tiger forwards.
He does, but I reckon Matthew Richardson was entitled to lead where he did because it was Leon Cameron with the footy. It was just a terrible kick.
Leon Cameron's just had a shocker tonight, hasn't
he? Foot.
Barnard went to Hurd. He's on the wing. What a bad kick from there off his step. Fiora did very well. Body to body with McVay and beat him. Breaks away now. Through half back, drives it down towards half forward. Richardson again. He hasn't stopped working. Give him credit.
Yeah.
And the ball goes across the line.
I think he's run Danny Jacobs into the ground. And if the disposal was better almost every occasion this quarter, I reckon half a dozen times he's had 5 or 6 metres on Jacobs. And maybe Fletcher's now had to go to him.
Yep.
Throwing out his side. Henneman backhands it down. Campbell in front. Peverell claims him. And again, the Tigers forced to go to the boundary. 93 plays 32.
It's a good call, Gary, because Kevin Sheedy's always acutely aware of the tolerances of his players, and he swapped Jacobs and Fletcher. He's probably given Jacobs a bit of a breather.
Strength. Jason Johnson won the battle. Kicks down towards half forward. Awkward bouncing ball. Zantuck went at it. Viora been handy in the last 5 minutes. Off the ball. Free kick to the Tigers. Advantage is paid. Zilla goes wide. This is Hall. Waste no time. Feeds it out wide. Bowden. His 18th possession. Spears the pass in. Matthew Knights has got it. Hard against the line. Barking the instructions. Peveril put a hand in. That was enough. Roden goes after it. Brilliantly done. Great carriage and great skill. So often a factor in his game. Moorcroft got it from Massidi. Kicks down towards half forward. Killaway over the top.
Handball's off. Viora to half forward. Cameron gets it again. Can he do something this time?
Gee, I haven't seen Leon Cameron turn the footy over like this for a long, long time.
11 clangers to Richmond, just the 4 for Essendon. And when you consider how much more of the ball the Bombers have had, it's been a lesson tonight as Massidi goes forward. Have a look at Johnson. He deserves a hard ball get here and a goal. In the end, he got up again, beat them all, tried to knock it out. Pinned and a ball up, and that is absolutely sensational football from Jason Johnson.
He's fantastic the way his second efforts at it. Leon Cameron, Gary, you mentioned it, he's turned the ball over tonight. You'd almost suggest Danny Frawley would think, well, if he can't hit the target, he's in there just to hit the target, really. He's not much use to
it. No, they'd be having a look at him. He's had a night that he'd rather forget. And look at those disposals. It is an enormous gap, and the game is being played like that.
Johnson's had 15 disposals and 5 clearances tonight. That's Jason Johnson. And I tell you what, good luck, boys, in picking out the 3-2-1 for the magnificent Monaro.
Your go, guys.
Thank you very much, Tim.
It's 93-32. We've played 21 and a half minutes in the third term. Once again, deep in the Bombers' forward line. Umpire straining on the bounce. There's Johnson again. That's his 6th clearance. Just misses the goal. Deserved one. But he'll get another chance because he puts himself right in the action every time. 94-32, the Bombers well on top.
Kick wide, too wide, over Houlihan's head and bounces across the line.
Joel Bowden, the player, again, someone that should do better than that with his disposal. Not a free kick because he played onto himself out of the goal square. No one touched the ball before it went out of bounds.
Jason Johnson, 16 possessions, most of them. In close and tough. Tawney, that's better. Shrugged the herd tackle, kicks down towards half forward, out of bounds on the full.
Back again, Jacobs, with Richardson, so might have had a little spell. Back just, he comes.
Just had a breather.
Yes.
Jacobs up towards the wing, Bolton in front. Knights going nowhere. Campbell out wide. Zilla again forced right near the boundary line. Delicate kick. Well, Roden did well. Strong hands in that situation. Spots him out towards the middle. Cameron alongside the centre circle.
Oh, well worked, Matty Richardson. He's run real hard here.
It goes in his direction. Or is it Ottens coming up behind him? It was Ottens who was the intended target. Richardson got the crumb.
Get
upended.
There.
And that tackle may have helped him. No, just to the right of behind.
Well, he worked. I just watched him solely then, Gary. He actually was a viable option for the kick that went to young Roden. He is just working so hard, and he's actually in front on every lead. He is working his proverbial butt off.
Cracker off for Hilton. Richo's kicked 1-3 for the evening. This bloke has had plenty of it. Blumfield, what a night he's had. To centre half forward, Lloyd flies. 23rd disposal for Justin Blumfield. Hurd gets the ball out again. Lloyd flicks it out wide, looking for Massidi. They're just outside the 50. Massidi back to Lloyd, who crashes through. Look at that. The old don't argue came out. He was pinned.
That's on the ball. He took
it. Of course it is. Yeah, of course it is.
He put up the arm for the fend off.
Ball up, though.
Joel Bowden was suggesting as much as well.
55 out from the Bombers' goal.
Look at those clearances.
Moorcroft hard at it. Also in there, Mark Bolton, who came on about 5 minutes ago for Hill, and Kevin Sheedy's back on the phone.
He's had that magnetic board working all night. they're moving them around like Chinese checkers.
The full forward spot's been worn out. There's nothing there.
Still 55 out. Plenty of effort from the umpire. You could hear him there. As he bounced the ball. Moorcroft just gets the boot on the ball, but it opens it up for Peverell. Flicks the ball out. Richards. Look at that. On to Peverell from Johnson. And Peverell misses to the far side just.
Say that at, for the little we've seen of Damien Peverell over the last 12 months, that's probably the one area he has a, not a weakness, but a slight deficiency in his game.
It's ungainly. It's an ungainly kicking style.
Yeah, it's a little bit slow hand to foot, but gee, he's a good player.
Zantuck decides to run it out and then kicks for the boundary line. Well, hasn't found it. Heard, tumbled over. Effective kick.
Good kick.
Yeah, wasn't it a good kick? Tawny breaks away. Roden, forward of the wing. Hasn't got the carry. Richardson running to the pocket. Jacobs ambles away. Richo feeling the effects. Jacobs, though, kicks it straight to Hilton.
50.
It'll be coming back quickly. Bolton a step or two too late. 50 metres against Mark Bolton. So back he comes. The big man.
Well, I made the mistake of jumping off the ground, and it wasn't vicious or malicious. It was just stupid. It was a forgettable piece of play. The players this quarter have just started to miss targets on a regular basis.
Hilton jabs it to the pocket. Richardson's got it. Richardson off a step. Kellaway deep in the pocket. Not sure about that one.
Had he kicked it straight to him, Dennis, it mightn't have been too bad, but the kick drifted probably 5 metres to the boundary side. And, well, look at the setup here of Andy Kellaway.
I thought he was going to just start facing the inside.
Like a rugby
play
union.
On, yeah.
We've got the probabilities anyway. I would have thought insufficient data. Here's Kellaway.
They're relatively low.
30 metres out. Steers at goalward. Good ball. I think he's got it. Great kick.
Oh. Well done, Andy Kellaway there. That was the probability there. Wouldn't have been all that high, you wouldn't think, for Andy Kellaway from the pocket.
Next time he'll be 100%. He set a high target.
Oh, he's mishit it. He hit that off the outside of his foot, and that's why it came back so far. And he rode it through. Yes, I meant it. Well done, Andy Kellaway. He's a good fella. Good player.
Welcome back, and Andrew Kellaway's 18th career goal reduces the margin to 56 points. 27 minutes gone in the third term. Massidi, once again, they walk out of the centre. The Bombers, Blumfield again, up to the forward 50. Lloyd punched away by Gasper. Crashing through is Ted Richards. Back it goes to Moorcroft. Kicks forward, lucky bounce. It might bounce through itself. King for the Tigers. Good clearing kick, that one. Kept it along the boundary line and picked up some 60 metres, and we'll have a throw in with 53 seconds on the clock in the third term.
3-1 quarter from a Richmond point of view. It's only a narrow victory, but it's a victory nonetheless.
They've outmarked Essendon by 2 this quarter, so the old theory runs correct with Richmond. If they outmark their opposition, they score better.
Ramanauskas got it from Peverell. High ball down towards full forward. Barnard almost. Heard slid in. Eventually it comes to Richards. High ball. They'll contest about 15 metres out. Gaspar has been so resolute back there. Massidi. Well, he had Moorcroft on in the square, but it came quickly. A lot of players between he and Moorcroft, and he kicks it behind. Should have done better.
I think Gaspar's been terrific as well. For the amount of opportunity that Matthew Lloyd had, he hasn't played conventional full forward, Matthew Lloyd, but he has had a lot of ball directed to him. And one-on-one, Gaspar has done a marvellous job.
Here's Campbell driving it out towards the wing. Kellaway got their last goal. Takes the mark in front of Force tonight. 20 seconds to go in this term. 96-39. The margin was 67 points at halftime, so that's been slightly eroded. Bowden short. Fiora. King wants it alongside. It goes to King now. It's a race against the clock. It's down to 5 seconds. He kicks it long. Hilton is there. Bolton did well. The danger is past. It's three-quarter time.
And the Bombers go in 14-12-96. Leading the Tigers, and Danny Frawley, plenty to think about. He revved the team up, 5-9-39. He gave them a good rev at halftime. And I suppose the positive thing for the Tigers is that they did respond in that term to outscore the Bombers. 14-12-96, Richmond 5-9-39. We'll be back with a final term after the break as Coach Kevin Sheedy, out there for the 750th time as player and coach, plots the demise of his old team. Bombers well on top. We'll be back right after the break. Welcome back. Well, Russell Crowe is a well-known Tiger fan. He's won one Academy Award, been nominated on two other occasions, and certainly the acting is rubbing off on some of his Tiger players.
Yeah.
The Bombers 14-12-96 lead by 57 points, having led by 67 at halftime and 41 at quarter time. Let's have a look at the goal kickers. And for the Bombers, it's Blake Carosella with three goals. Lloyd's got two, Blumfield two, Barnard two, Hurd two, and a couple of players there, Massetti and also Ramanaskas and McCurry with one apiece. For Richmond, Richardson, Callaway, Roden, Houlihan and Ottens have all kicked singles. Let's go down to Tony Jones with Mark Harvey.
Yes, thanks very much, Eddie. Well, Mark, a pretty ruthless display from you blokes tonight.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a big build-up to this game, and our players have come out firing, and although that quarter they started to turn the ball over a little bit, which we weren't happy about, and we let them back in the game, but hopefully we can get back on track this last quarter.
Well, go and enjoy the next 30 minutes, Mark.
Thanks, Tony.
Mark Harvey there, the assistant coach of the Bombers, down to Dr. Peter Larkins.
Yeah, thanks, Ed. We saw Joel Bowden come back with a vengeance that quarter, still carrying a bit of a cork thigh, but obviously that ice and stretching with the Richmond medical staff has sorted him out. Mark McCurry, not so good. Still getting some more attention to the left groin over three-quarter time, Ed. I expect him to come to the bench and probably not be risked again tonight, so probably no Mark McCurry. We're just seeing if he comes back to the bench now.
Well, Dermot, as you'd expect in a game that was blown open in the first quarter and then further widened at half by half-time, the uncontested possessions for Essendon all over the ground. They've had 166 to Richmond's 124, which is 42 more, not to mention their loose ball gets and hard ball gets. But it just means they've worked so hard and they run so hard and they've been able to create so much space that it's a bit of a damning reflection on Richmond tonight.
Absolutely. Look, Richmond try and handle the ball as least amount of times as possible and kick it to their big guns to mark it, so they can rely on a low possession game. Essendon, 259 possessions for 14 goals. They're kicking a goal every 18 possessions. Richmond, kicking a goal every 41 possessions tonight.
Bombers lead by 57 points. Hill goes up, knocks it down, follows through, knocks it forward. Johnson, who's been terrific, onto the loose ball, kicks well inside the 50. Loose at the back, Fiora. He's been good since halftime. Deep in his own defensive area, swings it out wide to accommodate Hilton. Hits the ground running, short one on to King, forward of half-back. King through the centre square, Knights on the lead, juggles it, takes the mark. So what about going? Matthew Knights feeds it back towards Campbell. By his standards, a poor night, kicks towards half-forward, forced to Knight. The 2-15s go after it. Cameron knocks it to his own advantage, close to the boundary line, kept it alive. Roden, Ottens running out of space. Cameron hard against the line. High ball, Ramanauskas did well, reaching over the top. King with courage, snaps it towards full forward. Richardson marks 15 metres out, wants to go. Well, I don't know about the wisdom of that. Although Kellaway's in goal-kicking form, who is that?
Well, Matthew is shaking the head and wondering why he didn't get it back. He's had taken 10 marks and his work rate's been wonderful, but he just forgot himself then. He had to go back and kick the goal.
That wasn't a good Kellaway.
Last time I saw that happen was the wizard Jeff Farmer went to handball to his captain down the other end of the ground about 5 or 6 years ago.
Well, when you're getting flogged on the scoreboard, you can't give away goals like that. Richo marks 12 metres out directly in front and then gives a handball. No wonder Kellaway couldn't get on to it. It was the last thing he was expecting. The ball's on centre wing. Stafford. Well, he almost had a go at it. That was dropping the ball. Ball up.
He actually checked himself, didn't he? He thought, oh, I'll go for the boot here. Oops, it's a bit free. I won't even bother the...
Really, when you're that big, you should just sink the boot in. If somebody wants to put their head down, you kick it over the grandstand, don't you? At this stage of the game, let's be honest.
He's a thinking man's ruckman, though.
All right. Ramanauskas beat the thinking man's ruckman on that occasion as Barnard kicks around the body up towards the half-forward flank. King has been hard at it, gets it out to Houlihan. Houlihan kicks into the centre of the ground. Coming out to meet it is Kellaway. The handball is on. Tawney, long kick. This is the way the Tigers like it coming forward. And Richardson
he's
does
done
well.
Something.
He's done a hamstring.
Oh, no. Their night has just gone from bad
gone.
To absolutely disastrous.
Stafford has just come to the bench. Ray Hall comes on. And look at this. If the scoreboard isn't tragic enough for the Tigers tonight, 56 points. One of the absolute superstars of the competition and the bedrock on which this Tiger forward line is built. Matthew Richardson limps off with a hamstring. Dr. Peter Larkins, Richo tonight, 12 disposals, 11 marks, 1 goal, 3. He has ran himself ragged, so much so that it looks like he has pinged that hamstring.
No doubt about it, Eddie. Certainly got some problems with the left leg. Barely able to hobble to the bench to get off at the moment. Really in a lot of pain and very fatigued from all the running. So they'll just have a look at him. Stafford came off looking quite proppy as well, Ed.
Massetti got it to Blumfield. There's Richardson. Well, as we said, it couldn't get much worse. This is Richards, forward of the wing, making his debut, kicks it down towards centre half forward. Lloyd comes on the lead and takes the mark. Well, weight of numbers eventually had to work against Gaspar. Matthew Lloyd will kick from right on the 50.
Well, at the risk of trotting out an old cliche, you reckon a week's not a long time in football. These blokes walked off this ground 7 or 8 days ago, having celebrated a pretty impressive victory with their two big stars in dominant form, and it looked like the unearthing of another big ruckman in Greg Stafford. And here we are, Matthew Richardson, let's have a look at it. Left leg, hamstring, bang,
right
there.
In the middle.
4 to 6.
Right in the middle.
Sorry, Doc.
Matthew Lloyd. Get the feeling distance won't be a problem. Just leans back. Hung it out to the left. It's behind.
Do they kick him further these days, Gary?
Well, I reckon the good players do. And Matthew Lloyd is one of the very best. He would be the man you'd almost get the kick for your life if you had to plonk on someone.
On that case, you're dead. 2 goals, 3.
Not from there, I wouldn't have staked that.
I'd take Brad Ottens myself. For my life.
He's in trouble here.
Gee whiz, what a night.
I think I'd want to kick it myself, actually. The incentive would be far greater.
Wayne Campbell's just had one of those horror nights for a skipper. Ball up. Just the 12 disposals, but it's all gone horribly wrong. Blumfield gets it out. Hurd, he wants another goal. We'll have another bounce, take two. Campbell in hard. Let's get into Dr. Peter Larkins for an update.
Yeah, Matty Richardson confirming, Ed, a significant left hamstring right in the major part of the hamstring. Looks quite significant. Could be a 2 or 3 gamer. And Eddie hit the interchange bench so hard with his right hand, I think you'll need an x-ray to make sure he didn't break that. Very frustrated Matty Richardson to see him on the bench there.
Missed 3 with a hamstring and 6 with a broken hand.
That's not that has actually happened before. Andy Bennett, the former Hawthorn player in the 80s, he had a chronic groin injuries and he came back once and they said take one more week, and he punched the wall, broke his wrist. Missed about a month after that.
We could reminisce all night, Derm.
Yep.
It's not going to help the Tigers.
No, not at all.
And once again, an ordinary kick forward by Leon Cameron. Ted Richards for the Bombers to Wellman. The kick out wide, Fletcher, he's just had one of those great nights out at the office. He has been fantastic. Look at that, just chips it forward. Two options are there. The one taking the mark is Force tonight.
Oh.
Macedi comes unstuck. Here's a chance for Zilla. Clinton King has tried very hard. Centre wing, he kicks it forward. Roden at the front of the pack. It goes to the back, though, and Johnson relieves again for the Bombers.
Fletcher very good there, too. Jacobs around the other side. Chips it close to the boundary line. Force tonight. 14-14, 5-10.
Bit proppy, Dustin Fletcher, after that marking contest, just back there with the trainers.
Well-weighted kick. Bolton made his debut against the Tigers, round one, 1998. Pulls it back towards the middle. Gaspar standing firm again. Plays on. Houlihan, right half back, steps around Lloyd, prods it up towards the wing. Knights, very untidy. Rogers, Campbell. Past Peveril, kicks down towards Harford. Nice finish. Hall's got it, 50 metres from goal. Comes back a long way. Down by 58 points. Hall, to give this one a ride, gets onto it too. It floats towards the pocket, though. Ball Bombers. Jacobs decides to run it away. Jason Johnson will have to work here. He's outnumbered 2-on-1. The boundary line is near. The boundary throw.
He ran into the big pot there. Carlton United pot. He put his hand up into the head of it. Got to amuse myself now, Gary.
It's a bit like that, dude.
Running out of steam.
I'm just
here
watching Dustin Fletcher, who's been with the trainer and the physio for the past couple of minutes. He looks pretty sore. Wouldn't be surprised if Sheeds gets him off.
He's
sure
clever the way he sported that one. He got hurt into that contest.
There he goes again, Johnson. Well, won't be his shout tonight, I can tell you.
This bloke's out of night too, David Peveril.
Yep, handball's on. Carousella checks his kick, then kicks forward. And the mark has been taken by Tawny ahead of Hurd, who has a bit of a go.
He did. He gave it to his teammate there.
Yeah. Well, the Bombers have dropped off. There's no doubt about it. In fact, the entire game has dropped off. James Hurd looking for perfection. Kellaway up high. takes it to the ground and to the boundary line. We'll have a throw in at half forward flank for Essendon, right in front of the smoker stand here on the members' side of the MCG. 8.5 minutes gone. Bombers are 14-14-98. Richmond are 5-10-40. It's Essendon leading by 58 points. Ottens again gets to the front.
Oh. Chopping, Richmond.
You heard it, chopping. Ottens gets the free kick, steps around Barnard, has a bounce, almost loses it. Handball's on. Roden has to juggle it. Back to Ottens. Ottens has to kick a torpedo from 90 metres out because no one was home. It wasn't a bad effort either. He got onto it. Cameron seems to be labouring out there at the moment.
He's lame as well, Ed.
Forster Knight kicks out to this man, Johnson. How many stats? We'll get them for you in a moment. He has had a ball on a string, and he does it again. 20 disposals to Peverell. Peverell's had 21. Richards hard at it. Campbell does the right thing and takes it to the boundary line. Gets a knee in the ribs for good measure. And the umpire says to his boundary colleague, throw it over your head. Jason Johnson, 20 disposals tonight.
And they're all been very well earned as well.
Head to head here, Blumfield and Bowden, 26 touches Blumfield, Joel Bowden 22. A couple of Bowdens have been little kicks out from fullback though, a couple of soft ones in that.
Barnard knocks it goalward, Pepperell again, 22nd possession then from 50, sets it up for Lloyd, Gaspar in from the side, loose ball at the back, Bird arrives quickly. Shrugs off one would-be tackler, pulls it back towards the kickoff line, slides to the opposite pocket. You had a kicker's eye view of that one, and Zilla knocked it across the boundary.
Matthew Lloyd asking the question, was I a chance to get a free kick out?
No.
Apparently not.
Boundary throw in. Ottens and Hill, well, they lock up very early. Gridlock. All close to the boundary line. That seemed to go out. Bird's got it. The boundary umpires over that side have been hexed tonight. It's like the Bermuda Triangle for boundary umpires. Down goes Peverell, gets it away. This is Massidi. Off his step, hoists it very high. Ottens in from the side. Bounced out of his hands. And Bowden decides, well, we'll go this way and see what luck we have. About the same.
Just big Brad Ottens would have eaten that up last week. That marking, here we go, Joel Bowden again. Another possession from a kick-in.
Bowden's kicked a point for each side tonight. Oh, no 15 on this occasion, as Knights has plenty of room to move. He brings the ball into Kellaway, to centre wing. Kellaway's kick is an ordinary one. King at the fall of the ball was good. To Hilton. Once again, disposal, not hitting the target. Enough time for Houlihan, who kicks to an empty goal. It could bounce through. No, it won't. And that sums up the Tigers night. And if you've just switched on and you're a Tiger fan, yep, you're getting done at the moment by 58 points. But also on the boundary line is Matthew Richardson, as we see. Dustin Fletcher, who was called early with that injury. We'll go to Dr. Peter Larkins in a moment. But he just looks a little bit sore coming off the ground, Gary.
Yeah, it's been for 5 minutes or so. He probably really could have stayed on had the game been tighter, but precautionary move.
No goals in this final term with 11 minutes to go. Tigers go inside 50, and Ottens gets his chance to kick his second goal for the night.
And it has been a lean, lean evening's work. We saw a statistic and a graphic before the games. He goes short.
Matthew Knights.
Yeah, 11 possessions to Brad Ottens tonight. Matty Knights, though, he's worked through the play, 14, maybe 15 to him. Still got the, suffered that blood nose in the first quarter. You mentioned Peverell before, Ed. 22 disposals for him for the evening so far. And we think of him as such a stopping player, yet Damien Peverell has taken the ball inside attacking 50 five times. Now, that's a sign of somebody who gets the ball in an attacking position as well.
58 points, Tigers trail. Knights comes in for his first score of the night. It is a major. The Tigers now trail by 52.
Well, it could have been, well, it still might be, but it could be a lot worse from a Richmond point of view. I think the scoreboard flatters them just a fraction. I think the Essendon have dominated this game to a larger extent than the scores indicate at the moment. But to their credit, they haven't touted in as we get a shot of the Essendon bench. Bit of talent on the bench. Fletcher, McCurry and McVeigh. McCurry may be the worst of those. And as we know, Richardson off the ground as well for Richmond.
Tigers have bitted the last three goals. Still, they trail by 52 points. 14-15, plays 6-11. Just over 10 minutes till full time. Friday night football from the MCG. Otten's up. Masidi grabs it. Was that 15? Barnard was thinking about it in midair, I think. Peverell, tackle, spilled out of there. Throw is caught. Bowden plays on, feeds it wide. Kellaway on the burst on the wing. Looks down towards half forward.
Oh, no.
Nice kick. Holland, Hilton, 60 metres out. Roden set a task. He'll be back first. Knights is there, tries to knock it to Roden. Deep in the pocket. What can he conjure here? He pulls it back. They kick four straight. Lovely.
Did everything right there, David Roden, didn't he? He led out for it pretty well. He found the ball was going too long and he had the awareness to nudge his opponent off balance. Mark Johnson, there it is there. That's the nudge off. And he took on Mark Johnson again. Not many people are going to take Mark Johnson on to evade a tackle. And steadies, accepts that he's going to get contact and still puts it through.
He's, as you see, Brad Otten's in the middle of the ground with his hands in the air, but he's got good leg speed, hasn't he?
Yeah.
So David Roden has kicked two rippers to open his goal-kicking account in AFL football. Both these goals obviously coming tonight in his second game of football. And the Tigers now trail by 46 points as we have the centre bounce. Let's get into Dr. Peter Larkins for the all-important injury count tonight.
Yes, Ed, Mark McCurry down here with the Essendon bench with hasn't been on the second half of the left groin injury. Dustin Fletcher, interesting, Ed, having his chest listened to by Doc Reid, either having an asthma attack or some problems there.
We'll come back, Peter's lawyer goes bang and kicks his third. 15 minutes gone, the Bombers answer after four consecutive goals from the 13-minute mark of the third term to the Tigers. And the Bombers just regained their equilibrium. Back to Peter Larkins.
Yeah, I saw that one coming, Ed, so I left it to you.
Good call, Peter.
So McCurry and Fletcher, just to summarise, Fletcher maybe with some lung problems, Ed, we'll check that after the game. Of course, over at Richmond, the big tragedy, Matty Richardson coming off the 3-minute mark of this last quarter with a left hamstring injury. Looks quite severe, icing it up, but expect that to be two or even three games. We'll check that after the game as well, Ed.
Thanks, Pete. Matthew Lloyd, 565 career goals. Three tonight. He's amazing, isn't he? He's found three and he's been the decoy full forward most of the night.
Yeah, it's almost to a break even now. He and Gaswitz been an enthralling contest.
Hill knocked it down. This is Bowden. Throws it on the boot. Ramanauskas. Wonderful balance. So much of the Kenny Hunters about him, I think. Comes across the ground. Jacobs. Barnard, a runner inside. He's used now. Jason Johnson unloads, wide of the mark. Pitches just inside the boundary line. It'll be thrown in, despite what Houlihan says. 105 plays 53. Blumfield at the right of that group. Good early. Fletcher, good all night. McCurry, good early. Campbell, hurriedly, runs it out of bounds on the far side.
There's no doubt about that too, Dennis. Essendon have certain players that just stand up when the game is there to be won. They've got a certain amount of players who take the heat, go out there, win the game. And you see a couple of them sitting on the bench now. They've done the hard yards and they earn the reward.
Ottens beaten by Bolton. Good balance from King. Houlihan comes away, aided by Bowden. Kicks it up towards midfield. Knights inside the centre square. Heffernan called back, not the umpire's favourite tonight. Hilton, awkward half volley, gets to his feet, breaks away. Interesting kick. Tivendale back to Knights. Not a lot of confidence amongst the Tigers. Roden on the lead, coming across in front. Matthew Lloyd.
Going for a stroll in the middle of the ground. Wouldn't be surprised if he's actually on the ball at the moment, Dennis.
Got that one on the lead. Here's Heffernan, up towards right half back.
Heffernan finds his teammate Joe Masidi. Plenty of room. He kicks forward. Carousella on the half volley. And a bit of a shove. Clean bowled his teammate in Richards. Good attempt as Fiora clears for the Tigers. Rogers.
Been quiet, Rogers.
He has. Out wide. Zilla. Inside 50. They worked it well, the Tigers. And guess who's lining up for goal? He followed his man down. And Darren Gasper gets the chance to kick his 15th career goal in 148 games.
Snuck down for one last week, did Darren Gasper against the Magpies, so he'd be fancying his chances. Goes short, in fact, and finds Big Ben Holland on the lead.
So, short again.
Oh, Cole, you do the comments.
Keep going, yes. Nice square up there. If it's not you, it's Peter Larkins trying to nick my job.
I thought it was a wise move, Peter, to hand it back to you if he liked his job.
Rogers is lining up. Only 8 disposals, 4 marks tonight for Rogers. He'll kick from about 40. We'll get right behind him here. 82% probability, 31 metres is the man on the mark. Comes in and kicks and nails the goal. His first for the night in the Tigers' 8th.
Matthew Rogers is an important player and a noted goal kicker, but his opening couple of games haven't been what he would like. But he's not alone tonight, Dermot. And I think there's plenty to take out of it from an Essendon point of view, though. And the two that stand out for me were Blumfield and McCurry early, two of their players who are just so important to them. They look sharp and back to their very, very best early in this game.
So some of the gloss coming off this for Essendon, 15-15, 8-11, 46 points. Could they get it under 40? They've stuck at it. Hill knocks it down. Peveril taken front on by Zilla. And the umpire wants it again. Roden, a couple of goals, beaten that time by Matthew Lloyd.
Hurt his shoulder a bit too in that little exchange of play, and he seems to be okay though.
Over the top, taken by Ottens, Zilla, Zantuck. The Zed's working, down towards 50, and Gaspar, suddenly a lively forward.
Down the tables, he has.
He's 55 metres out. Not his fault they're so far behind. There's Roden up ahead.
Well, if they get room for Roden, he'll be a good leading option. They don't get room.
Centering kick. Oh, Henneman did very well against Holland. Chips it out wide. Barnard in space. Overcommitted was King, but he's got support. Barnard spots a man up the field. 2-on-1 here. Needs it at the back. Well done by Lloyd. Carousella. He breaks forward of the wing. Plenty of time. Measures the options. Needs somebody going back towards the square. Bolton obliges. Hall trapped it. Tawney picks it up, lays it off. Bowden, nicely done. Fiora, back come the Tigers. Fiora drives it up towards the wing. King, now Richmond can take it and go. King spots Kellaway. The kick goes in that direction. Kellaway about 85 metres from goal. Holland comes on one lead. Worked out of it down there. Wellman wins the footy. He got rid of Ottens. On the wing, this is Lloyd. Kicks towards half forward, well-weighted kick. Carousella slipping in behind Houlihan. He's 55 metres out.
Carousella kicks inside 50, looking for Richards. Couldn't quite get it on the second attempt. Fiora, who has been very good tonight, as Dennis mentioned earlier, since half-time, kicks out towards the wing position, ball over the line and out of bounds. 14th disposal for Fiora. Let's go to Dr. Peter Larkins. Now, Pete, you saw the replay of young David Roden. You've picked something up about his shoulder.
Yeah, he still stayed out there, Ed, but the way he landed, he certainly would have stretched the ligaments in his shoulder, maybe even subluxed or partially dislocated the shoulder. So I'm sure they'll be checking that afterwards. He's still running around, but favouring the left shoulder.
Yep, on the ball at the moment. There he is. Looking for the handball. Did it well to Campbell. Campbell kicks out in front of Hilton, who couldn't hold the mark. Blumfield was there. Good vision. Held his ground. Then handball to Lloyd. That was great stuff. Good strength. Good skill. Forced the night back to Lloyd. Lloyd looks out wider still, looking for Hill. Comes from behind. Couldn't quite hold the mark. Diving on top. Bolton. Good play. McVay. The Bombers are queuing up. Barnard. Peveril was great. Hands over the top. Henneman kicks it out in front of his teammate, Ted Richards. Does it beautifully, and will line up for his first goal in football, the boy from Xavier College.
Good luck to Ted. He's got the surfy mop of hair. He looks like he should be down at Bell's Beach tomorrow. Final will be on down there tomorrow, Gary. He might even make his way down there, I'd say.
Yeah, wait for that. Dude.
Took the big mark on Almost Footy Legends 2 years ago, Ted Richards. Picked at number 27 in the 2000 draft. Played all of last year in the VFL. His first goal in football. We'll have to wait another week. Well, there you go.
I tell you what, when you see Matthew, let's have a look at this replay first of all. Just a slap across the snout. When you see Matthew Lloyd running around the field, picking up possessions at will, doesn't make you think how good he could be if he just wasn't a full forward. If he could play midfield, I reckon. He's that good, Matthew Lloyd.
I'd like to see him play centre-half forward.
Yeah, he could do that, no question.
Tigers bringing it out. This is Houlihan. Chips it up towards midfield. Taken by Rogers. Play is on. Goes very wide. Having to wait is Hilton. Will it get there in time? Not quite. Rogers did. Knocked it away. Goes back towards half-back. Lloyd fattening his stats. Chips it up towards the wing. Mark is taken by Moorcroft. 106 plays 59. Moorcroft saw Carousella lurking behind. Got the ball to him on the bounce. It's a high ball in. In from the side. Hill did the hard work. Dropped the mark. Bowden throws it on the boot. Heads for the boundary line. And gets it out in the right full forward pocket.
He was just travelling too quick, Barry, when he got to it, David Hill.
He did everything right, didn't he? Actually, if he can push forward, he covers the ground really well. I watched him run a couple of times tonight. He's a very good mover.
Don't forget Lucas out of Essendon selected side. Here's, he couldn't pick it up, the great man Hurd. Oh, right. Hang on a second.
That's actually a free kick.
That is a free kick.
That's just not on, Jim.
That's going on there.
That's a man's routine.
Now, that rule is actually considered time-wasting.
That could be a report.
It could be. In the old days, it would have been.
A show of dissent. I haven't seen James do that since the All Ordinaries dropped 50 points the other week.
And the other thing I haven't seen James do for a while is double grab at the ball. He's always the cleanest pair of hands, and that's why he kicked it into the crowd in frustration. We can forgive him that.
Drag him.
67,453 in at the MCG. A fantastic turnout again for Friday night football. So the Tigers have had 65 and 67,000 to watch the last 2 weeks against Essendon and Collingwood. Different result from last week, however, with 2 minutes and 48 seconds remaining. The ball is on half forward flank for the Essendon side. One last roll of the dice, you feel, for the Bombers here.
Johnson versus Zilla tonight. They've actually gone around together all night. So, look, he's brave, Stephen Zilla, but this bloke's been brilliant.
He was sensational just then. He got the ball working to Moorcroft. Moorcroft will get it back on the 1-2. Here comes the goal to the Bombers. And there it is.
A nice build-up, wasn't it? Jason Johnson just came on cue beautifully as the boys were talking about his evening's work. Stats don't always tell the story. He's won possessions in close and tight, which are often worth three or four of the ones that you can get standing out in the forward pocket on your own. And it was a nice little build-up. And Gary Moorcroft would be appreciating the run,
clever,
I think.
Kick.
Yeah, nice little kick, wasn't it?
Keep it low.
So the coach's box, they were still making moves on Kevin Sheedy's big night in the Essendon box. Can you imagine the static electricity on the board man's fingers? I hope he doesn't feed a parking meter later on tonight. Those coins will stick. Hill gets a hand pass across to Barnard, shrugs a tackle, Bowden in the road. Knights, Zilla alongside the centre circle. Zilla loops it down towards half forward. Tivendale unsighted tonight, 60 metres out, goes to the pocket. Buttons on the lead, takes the mark. He's about 25 metres out. Thought about going to the middle.
Unless he's called time on, that was play on.
I think he might have, the ump. He was standing alongside Wellman, setting the mark. Third mark for Ottens tonight.
Well, he's a beautiful kick. He should just go back and think of percentage and take it on himself to do something. For the team, 6 points better.
16-16, 8-11. They've plugged on, the Tigers. That's about all you can say. Sharp angle, misses near side.
Well, Bradley Ottens will be disappointed with his night tonight. No doubt about that. As you said, he's not alone. Just pushed off the ball in an earlier marking contest with Wellman, which probably summed it up. It was probably a state of mind more than anything else.
Only the 14 possessions to Brad Ottens tonight.
So 52 points the difference. The Bombers in front. They did get out to a 67-point lead midway through the third term. Umpire blows the whistle, and Matthew Lloyd, I think, will get the free kick. He has. It's been paid the advantage. Carousella over the top. Another chance for the Bombers. Ooh, Campbell goes to the ground, and McVeigh disappointed.
Very tough.
Very tough, as the umpire says there. Yeah, Mark McVeigh just wants the world.
Well, I reckon he's got an argument there. I reckon it should have gone back. It wasn't a clear advantage.
Throw in, I was certainly doing that earlier in the game, but I think the intensity's dropped off a little bit on the umpires as well, as it has the entire game. Rogers kicks it high and wide, out to the wing position. Bad bounce for the Tigers has been the case all right. Oh, Loynes with 33 seconds to go.
Just defending up. I don't think it was a straight arm intended to maim, wound or kill.
No, just a bit untidy. Cracker. Yep. For his first touch tonight, I think. One tackle, first touch.
And he
time ticking away.
He?
Yep, he was on for a fair while tonight, Andrew Cracker.
Well, he should produce some magic here and just bomb a big torpedo. So have some fun.
Well, he's going to have to. Hopefully he doesn't play on. He doesn't know there's 5 seconds left. But we do. Cracker comes in from right on 50.
Nothing.
Right up to the square. It's not through. That will be a point. Waiting for the goal umpire's decision.
That's not a score.
No.
No, because it was an assisted. It was punched through rather than off for hands. Yeah.
All right. Well, there you go. Final scores. The Bombers have in the end got home by a margin they would have loved to have taken at the start of the evening, but